Okay, so here's the new console layout, basically the same with some minor revision and then a spot for a 10 eventually. But working on getting a new camera. It's probably going to be a GoPro, but I'm going to go ahead and start working on this, and hopefully the phone will suffice for now. Okay, so I got the general shape done pretty good. See, there's that, and I don't know if it's in focus, can't really see the screen. I flush trimmed those just because I couldn't get the circular saw in there, and I can cut pretty damn straight with a regular circular saw. So what I did was, knowing this is going to be the inside, you can see the screw holes, took a piece where I knew there was a factory cut edge from the MDF, so you know it's perfectly straight, and just screwed it down there, flipped it over, flush trimmed it, screwed it down there, flush trim that, and then I actually could clamp it there. But the best way would be double-sided tape, something that releases but also holds pretty easily. But I know this is going to be the inside and the screw holes don't go through, so once this is covered and everything's together, you'd never know it's there. So about to cut the speaker hole out, and then the sort of access hole right there. Okay, so got the first speaker cut out. Thought I'd share this a little bit. Might seem like common sense to some, but you know, it's whatever. Basically, with the router, this is 3/4 inch I'm using for the sides. My current one's 1/2 inch. I wanted to make this one a little stronger, have it held together better. So since I want to flush trim the 10 inch mid that'll eventually go in here, what I did was measure out the amount that that bit stuck from under the circle jig to 1/4 inch. And since this being 3/4 inch material would still leave me a good 1/2 inch, which is plenty for any mid to hold on to. I could have gone down to about 3/8 inch and still felt good about it. So I did multiple passes at that depth, which give me this perfect circle flush trim. And then I'll be able to mount here, and then the speaker will sit down into here. So all that was I measured my, I put the pin at 10 1/2, cut this outer circle, moved it in just under 1/2 inch to cut, basically still fit in this first cutout, but also mostly hit the new wood. Cut that circle, same thing to here, same thing in, and then I dropped the bit all the way through the wood and then cut my final cutout circle. So okay, neighbor's AC is on, so sorry for the background noise, but so I've got everything how I want it. I rough cut the basically the amp access out of. This is where I'll be able to see the side of the amp. And then I'll have my little switchboard on the other wall, or not the switchboard, the sort of a distribution from the switches and the relay, basically right here, but on the other wall so I can get to it. So what I'm doing again is basically what I said, traced it over to this side, and then I'm just using the two screws with, the piece of factory cut, MDF as my straight edge, with the flush trim bit to basically cut this out so it looks as perfect as it can get. So that's where I am right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut this out. Okay, so I finished flush trimming out the center. You can see it looks a hell of a lot better than with the jigsaw, granted that it was sloppily rough cut, but all straight edges, probably gonna hit it with a round over. Okay, now since I'm going to cut out the second half, I want it to perfectly mirror the first half. So, traced it with a Sharpie, and then basically left anywhere from 1/8 to 1/4 inch extra all the way around. So now I can double-sided tape them together, and then hit it with the flush trim bit on the router to basically make two perfectly exact pieces. So gonna get to that. Okay, well I put the double-sided tape, I put one here to keep this side down, one here to keep this side down, And then I'm not too much worried about this, but this right here being sort of the flimsy long straight side, I put one right here, keep this down. So now you can see it's all sort of one piece now for the time being. And then I'll just have to use a flathead to pry up and get it free once I'm done.